Hey guys, this is Nitik and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will be showing you how to implement bubble bottom navigation bar. So this is the syntax of bubble bottom bar, and you have to grab this widget in the bottom navigation bar slot of scaffold. Here we need to provide current index, which will be maintaining our current position of our tab items. Then there is tap function, which will be called when the user taps any item on the bottom navigation bar. The border radius is the border radius, which will be providing according to your taste. In this widget, we even have an option called fab location, so that you can have a floating action button. Hash notch is another property of fab location. In the item section, as the name suggests, it will have the colors, icons, active icons, and the text to be shown when the particular item is selected. Alright, as you are familiar with the syntax now, let's implement the syntax in an app. When you are using a widget which is not there by default in Flutter, you should always head over to the pubspec.yml file and add a widget name below the dependencies section. And if you are using Visual Studio Code like me, then as soon as you save the file, it will automatically run the flutter pubget command. But if you are using some other type of text editor, then in the command prompt in your app directory, run flutter pubget. It should take less than a second to run. Then create a folder named screens in the lib folder and create a file in the screens folder named bubble nav bar dot dot. You can name anything you want, but I will always recommend to name the screen related to the code it has, because when you code for larger projects, it is always good to be organized. After you have created the file, create a class my home page, and in there we will have an integer named current index. Initialize the current integer to 0. After that, we will have our scaffold. Which will have the floating action button, which will be connected to our bottom navigation bar. Below that, we have our bottom navigation bar. set the opacity at 2. Have current index. And in onTap function, we have given our function name, changePage. The changePage function will be setting the value of our index in our current index variable. After that, we have our border, radius, elevation, and the items we want to include in our navigation bar. This time, I have given 5 items in the navigation bar, but it is upon your requirement on how many items you want. After we are finished with the items, now head over to the main.dart file in the lib folder. In the main.dart file, we'll import our bubbled navbar screen and we'll pass our my homepage class. Alright, that's all from my end. Thumbs if you like it, subs if you loved it. See you next time.